And joining the program now is Dreyer and Reinbold Racing Sage Karam. And Sage, 50% capacity for IMS is just announced today for the Indy 500. And I'm sure you and all the other drivers were eager to have fans at the 500. It wouldn't be the same without it. So what was your reaction to the news coming today that at least the plan right now is to certainly give you what should be a good number of fans?
Yeah, I mean, obviously, you want to have everybody you can, you know, be there. And, you know, it's a shame when some fans that really want to go aren't going to be able to go. But, you know, at least we're able to get, you know, quite a few in. And, you know, still going to be, you know, over 150,000 people, I'd say. So, you know, that in itself just shows how big this race is. And it's, you know, it would be odd without fans for sure, just because it's the single biggest, you know, sporting event day in history. So, I'm happy, you know, the drivers are happy for sure. I just wish we could get everybody in, you know, I'm sure everybody's thinking that as well.
I mean, earlier this month, Roger Penske comes and he says, hey, if there's no fans, there's no race. I mean, he's taken a strong leadership role for sure. From a driver's perspective, what's it like to have that type of a guy who's in charge of the 500 and IMS in particular?
Yeah, well, I mean, Roger's a pretty awesome person, you know. I mean, he has probably had the best IndyCar team, you know, since he's been in it, and he's been probably the most successful person at the Speedway. He's basically owned the Indianapolis Motor Speedway the last 30 years. He just made it official now, you know. But, you know, when you go to Indy and you race against Penske's, you know, you're usually chasing them. So, you know, he's a great guy, you know, putting all this in his hands. You know, we wouldn't want anybody else to, you know, have that power, you know, and I have full confidence in, you know, he's going to give us the ability to put on the best show we can.
Well, we learned this week that you'll be racing in the Grand Prix here at Indianapolis next weekend. How eager are you to be back on track in an IndyCar once again?
Yeah, I mean, it's been a long time coming for the Dreyer and Reinbold squad. You know, they've been pushing really hard to make it more than just an Indy 500 program. And this year, we were really looking forward to starting the season in St. Pete. We put a lot of work in, had some off-season testing. So it was looking really good. We were looking about doing, you know, 4 to 6 races this year. And then unfortunately with the pandemic and everything, stuff got postponed or canceled, and we had to switch our schedule up. So, you know, it's unfortunate, but at the same time, you know, I'm happy because now I get to race at the GP, and it was one of the races I really wanted to do that I wasn't going to do before. So yeah, I'm looking forward to it. We had a good sim day the other day down in Charlotte. So, yeah, I mean, I'm just going to go do my best. The team's ready to go. It's a big learning curve, obviously, but, you know, just really excited and looking forward to it.
Now, you mentioned the change in plans from earlier in the season. I mean, to be down in St. Pete and just a couple days away from debuting on the season, and then all of a sudden every plan changes. And some fans probably get it, but I'm sure some don't. Just how gutty that is for guys like you who have limited opportunities, but now finally you get at least a little bit of a reward being able to be back in an IndyCar again.
Yeah, I mean, it wasn't even just me. You know, there's guys that moved up from Indy Lights and guys who've been chasing full-time rides and have got those, you know, that were looking forward to getting going in St. Pete, and then they had to wait, you know. So a lot of guys that were really pushing to make this, you know, dream a reality for a long time, you know, had to wait a bit longer. So, yeah, I mean, I'm looking forward to it, like I said, that we're actually being able to get the season going again. It's cool that, you know, it's one of the first sports back that we can, you know, show people, you know, sports fans, racing fans all over the world, you know, what IndyCar is. And, you know, I think the drivers right now just want to put the best possible show on for the fans because, you know, it's been tough for everybody. And, you know, the fans are what makes the sport go around. So, you know, we want to make sure that they get a good product because they've been waiting too long.
You mentioned your trip to Charlotte to work in the simulator earlier. What have you done to stay sharp over the past couple months to be able to take full advantage of the opportunity when it comes?
Yeah, I mean, it's been tough. You know, it's even like the gym I trained at, you know, had to shut down. And, you know, so then me and my dad, we basically made a little makeshift gym in his basement. You know, we actually drove to Ohio one day, almost drove to Indianapolis, to pick up gym equipment, and because that's how much we just needed to do something and keep working out and staying sharp for when we were able to come back to racing. So I've just been working out with my dad, so that's been good. You know, it's a father-son kind of bonding time, but can get aggressive sometimes in the weight room for sure, but it's been good for the most part. And then go-karting, you know, I just was at the go-kart track today up at Oakland Valley Race Park. It's where I grew up racing when I was a little kid. So you know, basically whatever I can do, and all these home workouts and stuff, you know, it's been difficult. We've been doing a lot of sim racing as well. You know, IndyCar and iRacing put together a cool little championship, and we had some success with that. So it was cool to get the sponsors like Wix and Dreyer Reinbold Racing, you know, up front and showing the fans what we could do.
Well, Sage, we are eager to see what you can do on the track at IMS coming up next weekend with the Dreyer Reinbold Racing car out there. So, Sage Karam, really appreciate the time tonight, man.
Yeah, thank you guys for having me.